Guys, it's your boy D White, and we are about to embark on this He-Man workout. I'm gonna call it a He-Man workout for reasons that'll be obvious to you in a little bit. But the code name for this workout is Whose Idea Was This? Like, you ever go somewhere with a group of your friends, and then you get into the middle of it, you realize that I probably shouldn't have done this, and you're like, whose idea was this to begin with? So you get mad at that person. That's what this workout is today. It was my idea, so you can just get mad at me. It's all good though, I don't care. I probably get mad at myself. All right, so we gonna do some full body. So this is primarily, the emphasis is on our core. As some of you may know, or if you don't know, I'm gonna educate you right quick. I'm back up a little bit so you can see me. Our core, from here, bottom of the chest, to here. All right, so a lot of you guys think core is just doing ab work, but that's not what it is. Your core includes all of this stuff. So that includes your legs and your glutes and all that stuff, because that's the core of your body and the strongest part of your body that keeps your body under control. So a lot of you guys think core is just laying on the floor doing abs. That ain't core. And that's part of the reason you may not have abs, is because that's what you think that what it is. All right. And so you land on the ground doing these ab exercises, you're not burning any calories. Well, core, you don't need to do any ab exercises. Your abs are gonna be there if you're doing enough core work, because you're burning a lot of calories, because you generate a lot of heat working this strongest part of your body, okay? But anyway, our workout today is going to be sets of 20. We got four exercises. The first one is gonna be goblet squats. We're gonna do 20 goblet squats with your dumbbell. And as you see, I got my trusty 50-pound dumbbell. All right, so you can use the dumbbells that you, if you got dumbbells for the last workout, or if you got dumbbells at home, you use the dumbbells from your last workout. It needs to be something that's going to be challenging for you to do. You know what I'm saying? So make sure that you got a weight that's challenging for you to do. You go to the gym, you play this video, you can do it at the gym. All you need is one dumbbell. All right, I don't think that's too much to ask in terms of getting your workout in. All right, so we got 20 goblet squats. All right, we're gonna do a reverse lunge row, all right, to really keep the emphasis on the core. All right, we're not gonna use any support whatsoever. And I'm gonna demonstrate all these exercises before we get started. We're going to do a single arm thruster, and then we're going to do suitcase squats, okay? So we're gonna work the obliques, we're gonna work the abs, we're gonna work love handles and glutes, and booty and quads and all that. You know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna go through and demonstrate all the exercises real quick for you guys. Practice them a little bit before you start the workout, so that you know what you're doing once the workout is going. What we're going to do is, no clocks today. Notice my clock is not up on the wall. No clocks today. We're going to go through these sets in terms of making sure that you get all the numbers. So however long it takes you to get the numbers is however long it takes you to get the numbers. If you're doing some little bitty weight and you get done with this workout in 5 minutes, that's on you. You just need to go get some more weight, or you need to do some more reps. You need to double the reps, you need to triple the reps, whatever it is. I got a 50-pound dumbbell, so I ain't gonna be doubling no reps. I'll be good. All right, so I'm gonna go through real quick, show you guys the exercises, and then we'll get started. Okay guys, a goblet squat. It's very simple. The goblet squat, you wanna use the base of your hands to hold the weight right here in the center of your chest, with your feet a little wider than shoulder width apart, and then you wanna go down in between and up. All right, make sure you keep your weight on your heels. All right, keep your core engaged. Move all the way down and all the way up, okay? Just next up. What we're going to do is we're going to put one foot by the weight, one foot is back. We're going to do a row. We're going to step back, step forward, other side, row. Step back, step forward, row. Our next exercise is going to be a single arm thruster. So I'm going to hold this weight right here. I'm going to squat. And press, squat, and press. Okay, so just make sure it's weight that you can handle for a single arm press. All right, and our last exercise is going to be a suitcase squat. Down to the floor, under control. Pause for a second, come up and squeeze. Down, up, come up and squeeze. All right, we're gonna do that on each side. Okay guys, get ready to get started. Remember, the most important thing is your form and your technique. All right, make sure you're going as low as possible in these squats in order to really keep your core engaged, activate your glutes and your quads, make sure you're working all the proper muscles. All right, do not speed through this. All right, you guys, we're about to start round one. Make sure your weight is proper. Make sure your weight is challenging for you. And make sure you're doing the exercises properly. Take your time. Think about where your body is positioned at every moment and do the full range of motion, all right? Don't speed through it. You wanna prevent injuries and get the most amount of work possible. All right, so make sure all the core muscles are engaged, no sloppy posture, no rounded backs, all right? Just make sure your posture is good and that your form is good, and this will be a great workout for you. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get started with the goblet squats. 20 reps, ready?
All right, we're gonna take 60 seconds and do it again. Round two, 60 seconds. Oh boy. Oh boy. Watch out.
Thank you.
All right, you guys, thank you for checking out the video. Hope you enjoyed this workout. It is definitely a good one. And remember, you gotta keep that core activated, man, all the time. Even if you decide to do some abs or something, do that last a few minutes, 5, 7, 10 minutes tops you need to spend on abs. But you need to spend a lot of time working your core because that's gonna help support everything else that goes on in your body. So make sure to stay tuned. There's definitely more workout videos coming. I think our next video will be calisthenics again. We're gonna alternate between, you know, weights and basically body weight, plyometrics, calisthenics type stuff. So be on the lookout for that. Thank you for supporting the channel. Please comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.